Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvenni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. And this is lecture number 4.2, fourth chapter, second lecture. We are going to discuss about the continuity equation. So in this lecture, we will derive the continuity equation, the Cartesian coordinates and cylindrical polar coordinates. So we recap from the previous lecture. So in the previous lecture, we studied about the types of fluid flow, flow pattern, steam line, steam tube, path line and the streak line. And in continuation to this, so here we derive the continuity equation in the Cartesian polar, cylindrical polar coordinates. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to derive the continuity equation in Cartesian coordinates and derive the continuity equation in the cylindrical polar coordinates. So the continuity equation is based on the law of conservation of mass. So the law of conservation of mass, it is very much known to us at school level. The mass neither be created nor destroyed. So that is the basic philosophy. So the continuity equation is based on the law of conservation of mass. So we consider a fluid flow passage, a diverging passage. So it is just a fluid flow passage. The section 1-1 is the entry point and section 2-2 is the exit point. And the fluid enters with the section 1-1 as property rho 1, A1, V1. So, rho 1 is the density of the fluid, A1 is the cross-sectional area of the flow and V1 is the velocity. At the other side, section 2, the density is rho 2, area is A2, cross-sectional area is A2 and velocity is V2. So, the rate of fluid flow entering the section 1-1 is rho 1, A1, V1. So, density into area into velocity, that is the mass flow rate. And rate of fluid flow entering, leaving the section 2-2 is rho 2, A2, V2. According to the law of conservation of mass, the mass inlet to the system is equal to mass leaving the system. Rate of fluid entering the section 1-1 is equal to rate of fluid leaving the section 2-2. And substituting rho 1, A1, V1 equal to rho 2, A2, V2. So, this equation you have to remember. And one more simplification is there. So, here we are dealing with the incompressible fluid. So, the above equation is the continuity equation for compressible as well as incompressible fluid flow. For incompressible fluid flow, particularly for water or any liquid that we are going to deal with this subject, rho 1 equal to rho 2. The fluid is considered as incompressible fluid. So, the continuity equation is simplified as A1 V1 equal to A2 V2. So, this conclusion A1 V1 equal to A2 V2 is very important that you have to remember for solving problem in this subject. So, continuity equation for incompressible fluid flow in fluid mechanics, A1 V1 equal to A2 V2. So, where A1 is the area of cross section at section 1, V1 is the velocity at that particular inlet section, A2 is the area at the outlet section and V2 is the velocity at the outlet section. And three-dimensional continuity equation in Cartesian coordinate that you are going to derive. For the three-dimensional continuity, derivation of the three-dimensional continuity equation, we consider a fluid element in three directions. So, the direction x direction, y direction and z direction. So, the A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H is the fluid element. And the length in the x direction is dx, length in the y direction is dy, and length in the z direction is dz. Now, the fluid, so we are going to derive the three-dimensional continuity equation. So, consider a fluid element of length dx, dy and dz in x, y, z directions. And let u, v, w are the velocity of components in the x, y, z direction respectively. So, u is the velocity in the x direction, V is the velocity in the y direction and W is the velocity in the z direction. And this is the fluid element. so that again we draw the diagram once again. Now the mass of the fluid entering through the phase ABCD in the x direction per second. So ABCD is the phase in the x direction, the fluid is entering here. So mass of the fluid, we have the formula, mass of the fluid equal to rho into velocity in the x direction plus area of ABCD. So rho is the density of the fluid, velocity in the x direction as we defined earlier u, and the area of this rectangular phase ABCD. So ABCD, this length dy and the vertical height dz. So dy dz. Now the mass of the fluid leaving in the x direction. So mass of fluid leaving through the phase EFGH in the same direction, x direction, EFGH. So once again the same formula. So the same quantity is entering and there is change in the property and the leaving on the other side. So rho u dy dz into dou by dou x of rho u dy dz into dx. So this is the quantity of the fluid leaving in the x direction. So the first quantity entering the x direction and this is leaving the x direction. So the mass gain in the x direction. So mass of the fluid entering through the ABCD minus mass of the fluid leaving through the EFGH. That is what the mass gain. So the substituting for the two. So rho u dy dz minus rho u dy dz minus dou by dou x of rho u dy dz into dx. So the first two quantities are neglected. So what is finally left out? Dou by dou x of rho u dy dz, and dy dz, they are the fixed dimensions of the object, fluid element. So that is taken out of the bracket. So dou by dou x of rho u into dx dy dz, where dx dy dz is the volume of the element, rho is the density of the fluid and u is the velocity in the x direction. So this quantity, what is the quantity? Minus dou by dou x of rho u dx dy dz is the mass gain in the x direction. So look at the component, dx dy dz is the velocity, sorry, the volume, and rho is the density, these two are constant, u is the velocity in the x direction. Now in the similar fashion we can write the equation in the y and the z direction. So what is the change? Look at the change. So dou by dou y rho v dx dy dz, there is no change in the volume, there is no change in the density, the only parameter change is velocity in the y direction. So dou by dou y of rho v into dx dy dz, and similarly in the z direction dou by minus of dou by dou z of rho w into dx dy dz. Now so the mass of the fluid entering in the x direction, y direction, z direction, and mass of the gain, mass of the fluid leaving in the x, y, z direction, everything is solved and we concluded with the mass of gain of mass in the x, y, z direction. Then the rate of increase in the mass within the element, that we have to calculate. So that is equal to rho d rho by dt dx dy dz. So dx dy dz is the volume and change in density with respect to time. That is what the rate of increase in the mass of the element. Now we write the conservation principle, net increase of mass per unit time in the fluid element, that is equal to rate of increase of the mass of the fluid element. What is net increase? So the gain in the x, y, z direction. The gain in the x, y, z direction. What is the increase in mass? That is what we calculated the last element. So combining all the three terms. So this is minus of dou by dou x of rho u plus dou by dou y of rho v plus dou by dou z of rho w multiplied by dx dy dz. So the combining the gain of mass in the three directions equal to dou rho by dou t into dx dy dz. So as we look at the equation, it is very simple, dx dy dz is getting cancelled. So what is left out in the left hand side? Minus of dou by dou x rho u plus dou by dou y rho v plus dou by dou z rho w equal to dou rho by dou t. So the term in the left hand side is with negative, right hand side there is no problem, it is positive. We take the term in the left hand side to the right side, that becomes plus. So then the continuity equation in the Cartesian coordinate system is given by dou rho by dou t plus dou by dou x of rho u plus dou by dou y of rho v plus dou by dou z of rho w equal to 0. And this is the general expression of the continuity equation in the Cartesian coordinate system for three-dimensional flow and compressible flow. So why this is compressible flow? There is change in density with respect to time. Why this is three-dimensional flow? Look at, we are considering change in the velocity in the x direction, change in the velocity in the y direction, and change in the velocity in the z direction. So three-dimensional incompressible flow. Now this is the general expression for Cartesian coordinate system, three-dimensional flow equation for the Cartesian coordinate system, and this equation we are not going to use completely. So we simplify. So for steady three-dimensional flow, the equation is simplified as for steady flow, what is the condition? Dou rho by dou t equal to 0. There is no change in the property with respect to time. Dou rho by dou t equal to 0. So dou by dou x of rho u plus dou by dou y of rho v plus dou by dou z of rho w equal to 0. Then we further simplify. For steady three-dimensional incompressible flow, the equation is simply, what is incompressible flow? Rho is constant. When rho is constant, we can take rho out of the differentiation. So it is simplified. Rho is taken out and taken to the other side, that becomes 0. So dou u by dou x plus dou v by dou z plus dou v by dou y plus dou w by dou z equal to 0. And this is the three-dimensional steady flow energy equation, steady flow continuity equation for incompressible flow. Further, we can simplify for two-dimensional flow. For steady two-dimensional incompressible flow, the equation is further simplified. So, dou u by dou x plus dou v by dou y equal to 0. So, we have to understand the derivation of the continuity equation in Cartesian coordinate system for general expression. So, this is the general expression. This derivation, it is very simple that you have to remember, and at least you have to remember the final equation. Then you should know the terminologies here. Dou rho by dou t, change in density with respect to time. Dou by dou x of rho u, the change in velocity with respect to x direction. Change in the velocity in the y direction. Change in the velocity in the z direction. Then we simplify the equation for different condition. For steady flow, incompressible flow, or two-dimensional flow. That you have to remember, and this will be useful. So we will solve the problem so that you can remember this equation for a longer time. Then two-dimensional continuity equation in cylindrical polar coordinates. So we straight away derive only two-dimensional equation in cylindrical system. So look at the fluid element. So we assume the flow through a pipeline. So flow through a pipeline is the example for cylindrical polar coordinate. And this is the, there are two dimensions we are going to discuss. One is the radial direction. So the radial direction is from the center of the pipeline towards the outer circumference of the pipe. That is what radial direction. And another one is asymptotal direction or the polar direction. So theta is the asymptotal direction. About the center, we are rotating, we are rolling, we are moving in the clockwise direction. That is what the clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. So here it is anti-clockwise direction. The fluid element, fluid is entering here and leaving on the other side. This is anti-clockwise and this is radial direction. So fluid is entering here, leaving on the other side. And look at the velocity. So here the velocity is entering with the ur and leaving with the ur plus dou ur by dou r dr. Here the velocity is increasing, entering with the u theta, and here it is leaving with the u theta plus dou u theta by dou theta d theta. And we have to, the similar fashion we have to consider the fluid entering here and the r direction, leaving on the r direction, entering in the polar direction and leaving on the polar direction. Everything we have to consider and we have to simplify the equation. So we derive. In cylindrical polar coordinate, the three coordinates are r, theta and z. So r direction, radial direction, theta is the polar direction or asymptotal direction, and z is the axial direction. What is axial direction here? Perpendicular to the board, perpendicular to the screen. Then here we derive two-dimensional continuity equation in cylindrical polar coordinate. Consider the two-dimensional in the fluid element r and theta coordinate. So, r is the radial and theta is the asymptotal or polar coordinate. Now consider the flow in the radial direction. So mass of the fluid entering the phase AB per unit time. So the same equation. Density, velocity in the r direction and the area. What is density? Rho is the density. Velocity in the r direction is ur and the area equal to r d theta into 1. So look at the diagram. R d theta is the arc length. So into 1 is the distance vertical. That is z direction, it is taken as 1. So this is rho ur r d theta. Similarly, mass of the fluid leaving this phase cd per unit time. Then it is again rho into velocity into area. So rho density, velocity is ur plus dou ur dr, area equal to r plus dr d theta. So multiplying, simplifying, rho into r ur plus ur dr plus r dou ur by dr, dou r dr into d theta. This is the mass of the fluid leaving the cd. And the gain in the mass in the r direction per unit time. So mass of the fluid entering the phase AB per unit time minus mass of the fluid leaving the phase CD per unit time, substituting from the previous two values. So this is what the equation, rho ur r d theta minus rho into r ur plus ur dr plus r into dou ur by dou r dr d theta. So simplifying, you will get minus of rho into ur by r plus dou ur by dou r into r dr d theta. That is the gain in the gain of mass in the r direction. Similarly, now consider the flow in the theta direction, that is asymptotal direction or the polar direction. The gain of mass in the theta direction per unit time. So mass of the fluid entering the phase BC and mass of the fluid leaving the phase AD. So substituting rho density into velocity through BC into area minus rho density into velocity through AD into area. So substitute the parameters rho u theta dr, that is the rho into velocity into BC, velocity through BC into area minus rho u theta plus dou u theta by dou theta d theta into dr. So that is the second part, rho into velocity through AD into area. So first term as it is rho u theta dr, second term we are expanding rho u theta dr minus rho into dou u theta by dou theta into d theta into dr. So first two terms are getting cancelled. So what is left out? So the gain of mass in the theta direction rho into dou u theta by dou theta into r dr d theta by r. So the both numerator and denominator we have r for our mathematical convenience. And the total gain in the fluid per unit mass. So the sum of the two terms minus rho into ur by r plus dou ur by dr r into dr d theta minus rho into dou u theta by dou theta r d theta dr divided by r. Now the mass of the fluid element rho r dr d theta. So the rate of increase of the fluid element with respect to time. So this is dou by dou t of rho r d theta dr. This is equal to dou rho by dou t into r d theta into dr. So r d theta dr is the area of the two dimensional element. Now the mass conservation principle, net gain of mass per unit time in the fluid element, that is equal to rate of increase of the mass in the fluid element. And substitute in the parameters minus rho into ur by r plus dou ur by dou r dr d theta minus of rho into dou u theta by dou theta r d theta dr divided by r is equal to dou rho by dou t r d theta dr. Now look at the equation. R dr d theta is common in all the three terms, that is getting cancelled. So what is left out in the first term? Minus of rho into ur by r plus dou ur by dr, dou ur by dou r. Second term, rho into dou u theta by dou theta 1 by r. And right hand side, dou rho by dou t. So this equation we rearrange. So the terms in the left hand side, they are taken to the right side. So the negative sign getting cancelled, it becomes positive. So dou rho by dou t plus rho into ur by r plus dou u r by dou r plus r rho into dou u theta by dou theta 1 by r equal to 0. And the above equation is the continuity equation in the polar cylindrical coordinates in two-dimensional flow. So, this is the equation. And for two-dimensional steady incompressible flow, the equation is simplified. So, for two-dimensional steady flow, the condition is rho is constant. So, when the rho is constant, so in the same equation rho, first term is rho, here again rho is constant, that is getting cancelled. So, u r by r plus dou u r by dou r plus dou u theta by dou theta and 1 by r equal to 0. You multiply by r throughout. So, u r plus r into dou u r by dou r plus dou u theta by dou theta equal to 0. And the first two terms are combined. So, dou by dou r of r u r plus dou u theta by dou theta equal to 0. And this final equation is very important. For two-dimensional cylindrical coordinate, the mass flow continuity equation is dou by dou r r u r into dou u theta by dou theta equal to 0. That you have to remember for all our future discussion. So, here the derivation of the equation is also important. Continuity equation is important. What you have to understand the derivation and the final equations that you have to remember. So, it is a simple mathematics. You have to understand the logic in the mathematics. Then it is easy for you to remember the continuity equation for two-dimensional system or three-dimensional system in the Cartesian or polar coordinate. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I published in the mechanical engineering subjects. Design of transmission system, turbo emissions, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machinery. So, this book you can refer for additional information and problems. And also, I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the YouTube channel in mechanical engineering subject. You refer to it, use the video for your better learning and pass in the gate examination. So, thank you for watching. So, please post your comments on the comments box in the YouTube video and you subscribe the channel for your updated videos and you can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. So, we will meet again in the next lecture, next video lectures on the fluid mechanics subjects.